This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to show how to solve a 3x3 system of linear equations using the Gauss-Jordan elimination method. So here are the three equations we'll be dealing with. I've got 2x sub 1 plus 4x sub 2 minus 10x sub 3 equals negative 2. And then x sub 1 plus 3x sub 2 minus 7x sub 3 equals 0. And x sub 1 plus 5x sub 2 minus 12x sub 3 equals 1. So the first step is going to be to take the information that I have here and use it to make a 3x4 augmented matrix. I'm going to use the coefficients and the constants to fill in that matrix. So my first row will be 2, 4, negative 10, and negative 2. The second row is 1, 3, negative 7, and 0. And the third row is 1, 5, negative 12, and 1. When we do Gauss-Jordan elimination method, we want to start with column 1. We want to get the first element there, the one in position row 1, column 1, to be a 1. Right now it's 2. We're going to turn it into a 1 by multiplying it by its reciprocal, which means we have to multiply the entire row by that reciprocal. The reciprocal of 2 is 1 half, so I want 1 half times row 1, and that's going to become the new row 1. So 1 half times 2 is 1, 1 half times 4 is 2, 1 half times negative 10 is negative 5, and 1 half times negative 2 is negative 1. And then I just copy over the other two rows. Okay, once we've got the 1 in the position we want it in, up there in the corner, what we want to do is turn everything else in that first column into a 0. I can do that by multiplying the first row by negative 1, and then I could add that to the second row. That would turn this 1 into a 0. And I could also add that to the third row. So I want negative 1 times row 1 plus row 2 is going to become the new row 2. And in the same matrix, I'm going to also multiply negative 1 times row 1 and add it to row 3 for the new row 3. So for our next matrix, the first row stays the same. That's 1, 2, negative 5, and negative 1. And now we'll change the other two rows. I want to multiply row 1 by negative 1 and add it to row 2. So negative 1 times 1 is negative 1, plus 1 is 0, negative 1 times 2 is negative 2, plus 3 is 1, negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5, plus negative 7 is negative 2, and negative 1 times negative 1 is 1, plus 0 is 1. Doing the same thing for the third row, I want negative 1 times 1 is negative 1, plus this 1 is a 0. Negative 1 times 2 is negative 2, plus the 5 in the third row is 3. Negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5, plus negative 12 is negative 7. And finally, negative 1 times negative 1 is 1, plus 1 is 2. Okay, now the first column is taken care of. We go on to the second column. For the second column, we want to make sure there's a 1 as the element in row 2, column 2, and there is a 1. So now we can go on to turning the other elements into zeros. I've got a 2 in row 1, so what I'm going to do is multiply row 2 by negative 2 and add that to row 1. And that will get me my new row 1. And in that same next matrix, I'm going to multiply, I want to get rid of this 3. I'll multiply negative 3 times row 2 and add that to row 3 to make the new row 3. Okay, so I want negative 2 times row 2, and I want to add that to row 1. Negative 2 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. Negative 2 times 1 is negative 2, plus 2 is 0. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4, plus negative 5 is negative 1. And negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. Negative 2 and negative 1 are negative 3. Row 2 is going to remain the same, so I'll copy that now. 0, 1, negative 2, and 1. And then I just want to go on to the third row. I want to multiply negative 3 times row 2 and add that to the third row. Negative 3 times 0 is 0, plus 0 is 0. Negative 3 times 1 is negative 3, plus 3 is 0. Negative 3 times negative 2 is positive 6, plus negative 7 is negative 1. And then negative 3 times negative 1, times positive 1 is negative 3. Negative 3 plus 2 is negative 1. Okay, so that takes care of the second column. I need to do the same kind of approach for the third column. I want the element that's third row, third column, I want that element to be a positive 1. Right now it's a negative 1. So I want to multiply by the reciprocal of negative 1, which is negative 1. So I want negative 1 times row 3 will become the new row 3. The other two rows will remain the same. So I'll have 1, 0, negative 1, and negative 3, and then 0, 1, negative 2, and 1, and 0, 0, I'm just changing the signs here, 1 and 1. Okay, we've got a 1 where we want it in column 3. We have to turn the other two elements into zeros. So I've got a negative 1. I could turn that into a 0 by just adding row 3 to row 1 and making that the new row 1. I've also got a negative 2 in row 2, so I'm going to want 2 times row 3, and I'll add that to row 2 to make the new row 2. Okay, so I want to add row 3 and row 1. 0 plus 1 is 1, 0 plus 0 is 0, and 1 plus negative 1 is 0. I've got a 1 and a negative 3, that's going to be negative 2. For row 2, I want to multiply 2 times row 3 and add it to row 2. 2 times 0 is 0, plus 0 is 0. 2 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. 2 times 1 is 2, plus negative 2 is positive 2. And 2 times 1 is 2, plus 1 is 3. Now just copy over my third row. The left side of my augmented matrix is in reduced row echelon form. I'm sorry, this should have been, I forgot to turn that into a 0. I'm in reduced row echelon form, which means that the right side of the matrix is going to have the solutions to my original problems, my original equations. That means that, oops, x sub 1 is going to equal negative 2, x sub 2 will be 3, and x sub 3 will be 1. Okay, so there are my answers. Okay, so whenever you do something like this, there are obviously a lot of steps and a lot of places to make mistakes. The best advice I have is do a lot of practice, check yourself as you go along, and be very, very careful. Take care. I'll see you next time.